Let's talk about distal clavicle osteolysis. I know that sounds like a mouthful, but this is actually a fairly common shoulder injury, especially in people that do a lot of manual labor. You see it in bodybuilders or weightlifters, but you can see it in mechanics and carpenters and people that have to lift a lot for their job. It's a fancy term meaning sort of a wearing out of the bone at the end of the collarbone, really right at that AC joint, at the end of the collarbone before the AC joint and the tip of the shoulder blade. And again, it's an overuse injury that develops over time, typically not related to any kind of traumatic event. You typically get this vague, dull, achy pain right on top of your shoulder with reaching up overhead or behind your body or across your body, and it's really uncomfortable. So a weightlifter really struggles with things like the bench press and military press, incline press, things like that. Or people that are manual laborers that lift a lot for their jobs have a lot of pain trying to lift things overhead, carry things, things like that. It's typically, again, something we can figure out in the doctor's office. We can examine you, a lot of times put, you know, examine your shoulder, point or poke on that one area, and a lot of times that causes pain. We can find pain with motion, things like that. On x-ray, a lot of times you're gonna see sort of thinning or wasting away a little bit of the bone at the end of your collarbone, and MRI will show it as well, where there's just sort of decreased signal in the bone there. Now, it doesn't always need surgery, even though that is an option for some people. A lot of times it can just be activity modification, so you back off of the weights for a little while or modify things at work, maybe try anti-inflammatories like ibuprofen or naproxen, and you see how it goes. We can also inject cortisone, not into the shoulder joint, but into that AC joint to see if that helps to relieve pain. On one hand, yeah, that's good because if it works, it hurts less. But if that gives you relief, you know that there is a surgical option if you get to the point where no non-surgical treatment's working. And the surgery is basically to cut off the end of the collarbone, either through a small open incision about half an inch long, or through the scope, you basically take out 5 to 10 millimeters of the end of the collarbone, eliminate kind of pressure between the collarbone and the tip of the shoulder blade, and people can get back to what they want to do. A lot of times if you catch it early, you don't need to have surgery, but for especially manual laborers, bodybuilders, weightlifters, that type of thing, sometimes surgery for distal clavicle osteolysis becomes necessary. Okay, have you suffered that condition? Again, it's a mouthful, distal clavicle osteolysis, but a really common, not really common, but fairly common cause of shoulder pain, but it really drives the people with it, drives them crazy. Have you had that? If you have, how did your doctor treat it? I'd love to hear your experience. So below this video, share your experience, how you noticed pain, what activities were bothering you, how your doctor tried to treat it. I'd love to read it, and I bet viewers all around the world would love to read it as well. Also, I record a couple of these videos every single week, so if you like videos like this, subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click the button in the upper right corner of the page. Again, I record 2 to 3 of these videos every single week, and they'll get delivered directly to you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video on distal clavicle osteolysis was helpful, and I look forward to seeing you right here next time.